Hey, this is Savlevar from LickNRiff.com, and it's time for another viewer request. And in this video, take a deep breath because we're going to learn Steve Howe's The Clap. First, I'm going to play it for you, and then we're going to break it down lick by lick with tabs on the screen and everything. I'm going to show you exactly how to play this, and I'm going to show you different ways to play this because Steve Howe changes his own arrangement from time to time. So let's begin. It goes like this. Okay. Before we begin, I need to prepare you mentally. You have to be prepared for what you're going to play. First and foremost, this requires quite a high level of Travis picking. And by high level, I mean, by the way, Travis picking, if you don't know, go learn Travis picking. But if you don't know, it's the thumb pattern going 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, on alternating strings. Okay? This is basically a Travis picking masterpiece. Now, in order to play this, you have to be at a level of Travis picking where you're already so comfortable with the thumb movement, the ragtime 1-2-1-2 rhythm, that you don't think about it. You have to be at a level of Travis picking where the thumb is on autoplay. When it's playing automatically, you don't have to think about it because the movement is so natural to you that you have enough mind space free to think about the rest of the fingers and what you need to play, the chords and the melody. Okay, if you need to think about the bass movement, this is going to be pretty difficult for you, but you can do it. You can learn the melody first and then try and put the Travis picking into it. It's up to you, okay? I have a Travis picking lesson, you can go learn it and then come back and learn the clap. Now, if you are at a level of Travis picking where the thumb is automatic and you don't have to think about it, then I have to prepare you that this is going to be one of the most fun and challenging guitar compositions you've ever played, because the theme of the clap is playfulness. It's a playful piece. It's got a lot of humor in it, but as fun as it is, it's also challenging. It's also very, very difficult to get together. I've been playing this for years. I think I've learned it about 10 years ago. And there are parts I still find difficult. Your fingers are going to get confused. You're gonna play it wrong. You're gonna play it in a different rhythm. You're gonna have a bit of trouble connecting the pieces together, connecting the different riffs. Don't worry. Give it time. Give it time. Have patience, and just learn it riff by riff. This is a piece composed of many riffs put together. Learn it riff by riff, okay? Don't move on to the next riff until you've got your current working riff down, okay? Trust me, I've been struggling with this piece for a long, long time before I played it right. Let's begin, okay? Take a deep breath along with me. Please do it. You're gonna need it. Another one. Let's begin. It starts like this. Okay, now right there is a place where you can change it, because Steve Howe plays it differently from time to time. He plays or. Okay, I like this version. Okay, I'm gonna show you all three versions. This is the first riff. Okay, this is the first riff. Now, you play, it's basically the same picking pattern throughout the riff. So, you bar strings 1, 2, 3, and 4 on the 7th fret. You add your pinky on 10 on the E string, okay? So you have a D chord. Now technically it's D over A, because this is an A note. Why is it a D chord? Because if you put a complete G-shaped chord with your bass on D, you've got the D chord. So this is a D chord. And you play the D string, then you play strings 1 and 2 together, then you play the G string with your thumb, because it's an alternating bass note. Now, I know that this breaks the rule of thumb plays D, A, and E strings only, but rules are meant to be broken, so, okay? Why is it important to play it with the thumb? Because that gets the rhythm going. Okay, the thumb gives a completely different feel from the rest of the fingers. So that's why it's important to play it with the thumb. So D string, E and B strings, G string with the thumb. Okay? So the alternating bass notes are, okay, bass notes, because these are by no means bass notes. So that's the first lick of the clap. Now, you keep the bar on, the half bar, it's not a half bar, it's a 4/6 bar, 2/3 of a bar, and you put on a C chord shape, Now you're gonna play a G chord, because this is G. Now, you play the same thing, only a string up. I mean up physically, or down if you want to go pitch-wise. But I like to say up because we're going up a string. I like to refer to it physically, so don't get confused. Now, you take everything you just played, you take it up a string. So, you play this. Okay? Same thing. A string, B and G strings, D string. Okay? Got it? Okay? So, together they sound like this. Now, the next chord is just keeping the bar on, third finger on 9 on the A string. Okay? That's it. Now, this is back to the D chord, because this is, again, a part of this. Okay? It's just a different part. We played this, now we're playing this. Okay? This is G over... D over F sharp, actually, because it's this, it's D over F sharp. Okay? So, you play the same thing. A string, strings 2 and 3 together, D string. Okay? So, now we're gonna end the part where the bar is on 7. So, let's just recap. Okay, so G shape, C shape, G over B shape. Now, you play this. What is this? This is an A chord. It's just an A chord. It's A over E. Why? Because it's an A chord with a bar on 5. Take the bar off, put the finger back on the 5th fret of the B string, of the 2nd string. Then you have this. And again, same picking pattern. Okay? A string, strings 2 and 3, D string. Okay? This is A over E because this is an E, not a chord, an E note. Okay? So, okay? Take this 2 frets back to G, G over D, if you want to get technical about it. And you've got this. Now, the picking pattern changes a little, because it's a whole bar. It's... Okay? Now, it's... It's the bass, then the rest of the chord. Where the next, along with the next bass note. So, okay? It's the A string, then the D string, along with the 2nd and 3rd strings. And then the 2nd half of the bar is this. Okay? Now, this is another place where you can change it a little. You can just tweak it to what you want to play. It's bass note, higher string, bass note, okay? You play the A string, then you pick either one of the high strings, strings 1, 2, and 3, just one string, and then the D note, the D bass, okay? The D bass, the D, this is confusing, I'm sorry. Okay, focus. The D string, okay, so A, one of the high strings, D, okay? Okay? Or... All of these work. Let me show you. Or... Okay, that was the first string. It all works. I like to play the first string, but I change it from time to time. Again, A string, B string, D string. Got it? So the whole bar goes like this. And then, to finish the riff, D chord. Now, I like to play the D bass, the chord, the A bass, the chord, then the D bass again. Okay? Now, Steve Howe plays this sometimes. He plays the bass notes, again, D, A, and D. And he just alternates between either strings 2 and 3 to strings 1 and 2. Okay, this was with strings 2 and 3. Bass, 2, 3. Bass, 2, 3. Bass. Or with strings 1 and 2. So, I like to play this, okay, because it gives it a definitive ending for the opening riff, but this works as well, okay, Steve Howe likes this, I just like this, okay, Steve Howe plays that sometimes. So, you're done with the first riff. Which is basically just the same lick going around on different chords. So again, D, G, D, A, G, D. Okay? Now without talking. Got it? Or, that's the first riff. Second riff begins like the first one. The first four chords are the same. Okay? D, G, D, A. Now, you slide this. You don't have to slide, you can just move it. I like to slide. Okay? And then you exchange the place your second finger and your pinky are. You take the pinky down one string, and you take the second finger up one string, and you create a C7 shape. Okay, you just exchange those fingers. Okay, let me just show you. You take the pinky down, you take the second finger up. You have a C7 shape, okay? You had this, now you have this. You just change the place, okay? You were here, a major chord, now you have this, a seventh chord. Now you have F sharp 7, okay? And you play this. Now, you change a bass note in between. You begin with the F sharp bass on 9 on the A string, and you take the third finger up one string to the C sharp bass. Okay, because then it will create this. Okay, the chromatic movement. The bass notes are going to have. So you prepare it now. You play this. Okay? It's this. Bass, okay? The A bass. Then the entire chord. Then the C sharp bass on the 9 on the E string. And then this. We were here. Then you play the E string. Open E string. Okay? So the lick is going to be this. Okay? What you hear when you play it is this. You just have the B string and the E string three times. Okay? Now, in the correct timing, it goes like this. Okay? Now, I said we're not going to go into Travis picking, but I want you to hear the rhythm. Bass, 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 bass. Okay? The notes are with the bass, between the bass, between the bass notes, then with the bass, between the bass notes. Okay? I know this was confusing. Let's try again. F sharp. Old chord, change the bass notes, E string, and then this. Got it? Okay, just try to play this. And then just add the bass notes. Try to hear it. Dun, dun, da, 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 da. Okay? Claps are bass notes. Okay? That's the rhythm. If you can't hear it in your head, you can't play it. I told you, if you have to think about the bass notes, you're gonna get confused. There's no way around it. You have to hear the rhythm in your head. The melody is... Okay? So... That's it, just connect the melody and the bass notes. I'm sorry, there's nothing more I can explain. Because you saw, I tried to dissect it, it was even more confusing. You just have to play it really slowly. Okay, look at my thumb. Okay, I'm gonna try and nod my head when I play the bass notes. The last bass note was a mistake because then comes this. Okay, don't mind it. Okay, and then right away you play 8 and 7 on the E string. On the E bass. With your second finger and then the first finger, and you bar the 7th fret. Okay, because then begins the next riff. Okay, so this is the second riff. Bass. Okay? I said bass where the bass change occurs. Bass. Okay? Don't forget to change from the F sharp bass to the C sharp bass. So that's it for this opening line. Okay? I know I forgot to change the bass notes. I just wanted to show you how it goes, how it all comes together. Now, you're here. You're barring the 7th fret yet again. Put on a 7th chord, okay? E7 shape. You're playing B7. Now, the pinky should be free because the pinky now plays a solo. The next riff is this. Okay? And then we're going to have the first big ending, and then you play the whole thing again, and then a second big ending. Now, this is just playing okay, it's basically the same shape moving around. Okay, you're playing B7, then you're playing A7, then you're playing G7, then you're playing B7. It's again the same shape, only a spring down, then back to G7. okay, with the pinky going around and playing a solo. Alright, so you already played the B bass, okay, and you put on the chord, the B7 chord. Now the solo is on the E string, it's 7 using your bar, 9 with your pinky, and then 10. So it's 7, 9, 10. Now, the first note is played along with the chord. Okay? Okay, so you play... I like the alternating bass notes to be the E string and the D string. Okay? Because both of them are on 7. So you can... So if you miss... if you don't keep timing and you miss putting on these fingers when you move the chord around, because when you do this, you have to do this for a second and then put on the chord. You don't have to, but it's more comfortable. So if your alternating bass note is the D string and both of them are on the same fret, then it's easier. You can still keep the bass notes going and just put on the chord a second later. I really hope you get what I'm trying to say, because this moves around really fast. And the seventh note is on the same fret as the bass note, so it's a lot easier to do. Instead of, you just play this. Okay, and that way you accentuate the seventh chord as well. Okay, you get two things done at the same time. So you play the bass note and the seventh note. Okay, so it was this. Now you can play the chord along with the solo notes. Okay, but I like to accentuate the chord once. When I play the chords, I like to accentuate them once. You can play them all throughout this entire riff if you want. Okay? So, bass, chord, 9 with the bass, then 10, then the second bass note. Got it? Okay, the last bass note comes after the solo. Then, bar on 5, the solo note is... It's 9 on the E string, then the bar itself on 5. Okay, so you can play this. You can play the bass, the E string and the B string. Okay? And that way you have sort of a fifth chord. And then you put on the chord. And you play the rest of the notes. Okay? So that way you kind of cheat. You cheat your way around the chord. Got it? You play... No G string, because this is minor and you need major. You can do this, but why? You don't have to. You can just put on the bar and 9 and pick strings 1 and 2 along with the bass. Okay, so it's... Now if you want to keep the bass notes going, you don't have to. You can put in a dramatic pause and do this. Okay? If you want to keep the bass notes going, just pick the D string. And then put on the chord and pick it. You have time. And then... the bass notes. No, actually you have time for one bass note, so play the A bass again. Okay, so this is the next lick. Play. okay? Just chromatic movement. G sharp, G. Okay? Just A, well, you are here. You take the chord down a fret, then down one more fret. From 5 to 4, then from 4 to 3. Okay? And then you do this. The solo notes are 3, 5, 7. I like to slide from 5 to 7, so I take the chord off for a second. If you do it fluently enough, then nobody notices because it's G7, and G7 is also played this way. And these two, these two strings, strings D and G, are inside the G chord, so you can use them as your second bass note. So, okay, I played the D string instead of this. It's inside the chord. So, you are here. Okay, you pick the chord again. Chord. And then 5 with the bass. Then I slide to 7. Or you can do this if you want and keep on going. This is a bit more, is a bit, it's a stretch. It's less comfortable. And Steve Howe sometimes slides as well. So he does it. If he does it, you can do it as well. Even if he doesn't do it, you can do it because you're going to play it, not him. He already played it for, he still plays it. He's playing it for about 40 years now, so you can play it in any way you like as long as you keep the original spirit intact. One slide wouldn't kill you. One change wouldn't do a difference. If Steve Howe can change the piece to his own liking, then you can change it to your own liking, okay? Don't be a parrot. Don't copy what a different guitar player does. If you like something else, do it your way, okay? Create your own sound. There's nothing wrong in it. If Steve Howe would have been teaching this lesson, he would have been telling you the same thing. Okay? Okay, because Steve Howe is a creative guitar player. He's an amazingly creative guitar player. And being creative, he knows that music is a living, breathing thing. And as a living, breathing thing, music changes. And that's why he changes what he plays. So if he changes it on stage, you can change it in your own room. So don't be afraid to experiment with different ways to play things. So again, okay, we were here, and then chord, 5 with the bass, then slide. Now you can even just slide it without picking another bass note, because you're gonna land on B minor 7 in half a second. So who's gonna notice a missing bass note? Okay? Okay? If you're so worried about the bass notes, pick the D string. Okay? Slower. Got it? Bass. The notes are with the bass notes, except for the last one, which comes before the bass note. Okay? Said we're not gonna go into crevice picking. I'm trying really hard not to. Anyway, now you're here. Okay? Now you put on the B minor 7 shape, add your pinky on 5, it's still a B minor 7. This is another shape, another voicing of B minor 7, without the pinky, with the pinky, it's B minor 7. And you play this. Okay, your bass notes now are A and D, the A string and D strings. The notes themselves are B and F sharp, okay? But I mean the strings you pick. I told you, don't think about the thumb. Okay, it's chord, bass, chord. And then two more bass notes. The only different thing about the two times you pick the chord is that one time it's with the pinky, the other time it's without the pinky. So the solo is 5-2, okay? Okay, and two, of course, is the bar. So, okay, so chord, bass, bass. 5, bass, 2, bass, bass. Okay, so it's two picking patterns which repeat themselves. It's this. And then this. Chord, bass, bass. Then the same picking pattern as before. Okay, as this. And then the same as this. Is this. Okay, so it's ta 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 ta. Okay, same pattern. Try to hear it in your head. Try to recognize patterns and try to recognize rhythms. The more you try, the more natural it will feel, and it will come to a place where you don't have to think about it. It'll come naturally, and you'll know where the bass notes should be. Along with the rhythm. So, okay, so let's just play this again before we end this riff. The ending is a bit different, we should focus on that entirely. Okay, so let's play this again. We were here. Remember? The F sharp 7. Movement 8-7-7 already is already on the B7 chord. Okay, so again 8-B7. Okay, slow. This isn't slow. This is slow. Okay? Okay. Now, the next lick might be the trickiest lick of the entire composition. Because of this. Difficult to play it slowly. It's this. Okay, this is the original version. Now, from time to time, Steve Howe plays this. Okay, instead of a bend, he slides it. Okay, instead of. And more recently, he's been playing this. Okay, so he's playing around with it. Now it's G7. Okay, let's dissect this. You're playing G7. Okay, and you're playing the bass notes are the E string and the D string. Okay. And the strings you pick are the B string and the G string. Okay, you don't pick the E string. You pick strings 2 and 3. Most of the time you pick them together. Now, the lick is this. 3. 5 pull off to 3. Then either 6-5-3. And then another pull off. Wait for the pull off. It's either 6-5-3 or 6-5-3 or 5, bend, unbend, 3. Okay, now the bend inside the chord. Okay, you see, it doesn't always work out for me either. It's a really tricky position. You need to really be in the mood to play it correctly. Okay, you really have to get into it to get the bend going. So again, now with the bass notes, 3, pull off. Okay, now here's another tricky thing. The pull off occurs just when you play the second bass. Okay, so you're playing a bass note and pulling off the pinky at the same time. This is a really tricky lick to get down. I suggest you be really, really patient with it. It took me a while to get it down under my fingers. Now, again, 3, pull off, 5-3. Then either 6-5-3, okay, or 6-5-3 as Steve Howe recently plays it, or the original rhythm, or a slide. Okay? I really hope you're following. I don't know if I'm getting this through, but I'm gonna keep trying anyway. So again, 3, pull off, 6-5-3. Got it? We're halfway there. Or bend. Or slide. It's the pull off again, and then 6-5-3 again, then the pull off again, then the 6-5-3 again, then the pull off again. Okay, so you basically repeat it. It's this. It's 3, and then you repeat this. Okay? Let's count. 1. 2, 3, 4. Okay? The fourth time you pull off, that's the end of the lick. That's the best I can do. So let's play it a couple of times in all of the variations. Okay? I'm gonna try and play it slowly. God help me. Now just the bend. Okay, the bend is really difficult to play slowly. So you see it's 4 pull-offs. Okay, now for the easier variations. Slide. Now for 6-5-3 in the original rhythm. Now for 6-5-3 in the newer rhythm. No, that's the old rhythm. Sorry. And now we're done with the first part of the clap. It's the most difficult part. It's gonna get a lot easier from now on. So pat yourself on the shoulder because you're done with the most difficult part of the composition. Let's play this last riff again. So the bend went easily. Let's play it from the top and then we'll learn the endings. Right? From the top. Understand what's going on. First ending is this. Okay? It's three licks put together. Okay? That's the first ending. Second ending is this. Between those two endings, you play again the entire first part. First ending, you put on D7. Now, put on D7 like this. Take the bar off, put your first finger on 5 on the G string, and you've got this. Okay? 7-5-7. 7-5-7 or 7-5-7, any way you look at it. It's a palindrome. No, it's not. You play this. Okay, that's it. You play the D string, then 2nd string, 3rd string. Okay? Then you play it again, only this time with an open G string. Okay, you take the finger off. Okay? And then you play again with the finger. Then again without the finger. Then again with the finger. Okay? That's it. You can pick the D string there at the end as well. So. Okay? Finger without finger without finger. Okay? So you pick it 5 times. Let's just talk about the G string. 5, open, 5, open, 5. And you can pick the D string at the end or not. Second part, second lick of this ending is you bar the 2nd fret and you play this. Okay? You play, on the D string, you play 5, 4, 5, 2. Between them, you pick 2 on the 2nd string. You're barring it, so you have 2 on the 2nd string. So, 5, 2nd string, 4, 2nd string, 5, 2nd string, 2, 2nd string. Got it? Then this. It's 4-2-0-2 on the G string. You pull off from 4-2-2-0, and then you pick 2 again. Okay, so pull off, 2. Then the same thing on the D string. Okay, so. Whole thing up to here. Got it? And then the second ending. The second ending is this. Okay? It's a series of, except for this one. This is the seventh chord. Except for this one, these are diminished chords. So the first chord is you put on two on the E string, three on the B string, five with your pinky on the G string. And you pick the A string first. And then you just pick strings 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then you pick the third string again and you slide your pinky from 5 to 8. And your first finger is now on 5. And instead of 6 on the second string, put on 7. Okay? So it's 5, 7, 8. So now the A string is, should be still ringing. So it's... Okay? You slid, and then you played this again. Okay, strings 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And then you play the third string again, and you slide it to 10. You slide the pinky to 10. Same shape. Again, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Then 3 again, and you slide it to 13. Same shape. Your pinky is on 13 now. So it's... And you pick strings 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay? So it's A, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 3. Slide to 8, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 3, slide to 10. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Slide to 13. 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay? Remember the change. Here, you use the second string. From here on out, you use the third, the second finger on the second string. And from here on out, you use the third finger on the second string. Okay? This is... 3 and 2, and from here on out it's 5 and 7, 7 and 9, and 10 and 12. Okay, so again. Okay, let's play the endings along with the ending of the previous part. Okay? Now the second ending. First part. Congratulate yourself. This wasn't easy. I know it wasn't. Trust me, I know. Okay. Luckily from now on, it's really short riffs. It's a lot easier than you think it is. The tricky part is getting them all together. Now, the next riff is this. It's G over D. Now, there are two ways to play this. First, you put your first finger on the E bass on 10 and your pinky on 13 on the E string. Now, your chord is strings 2, 3, and 4, either open or with a bar with your third finger. Use your third finger to bar on 12. So it's either a high G or a low G, okay? Steve Howe likes to use the high G a lot, and it sounds like this. the low G sound. Okay? Both sound awesome. So sometimes I play the high G, sometimes I leave it open and play the low G. Experiment with it, see what you like. Now, either way, the riff is this. Just 13, 12, 13, 12, 13, 12. Okay? The rhythm is this. Okay? Bass. Chord with 13. Okay? And the second bass. Now, the second bass is the G string, because you're playing D on the bass. Now, why not play the open D string? It's the same note, because then you have two open strings. And the ear recognizes two open strings, and it doesn't sound good. If you wanna use the open D string, do this. Just bar with your first finger on 12 on strings 1, 2, and 3. And then your alternating bass notes are the D and G strings. And then it's the best of both worlds. But Steve Howe knows what he's doing. He uses this note because it's a fat string, so it's a fat sound. This is a thinner sound than this. So it's a sound issue. If you don't mind a thinner string, then use the open D string. I like to use the original 10 on the E bass. So, chord with 13. Bass, chord. Bass, 12, chord. Or second bass. And then 13 with the bass, 12, second bass, 13, bass, 12, bass. Okay? Now I didn't play the chord along with it, so you could hear the bass notes going. Slower. Or with the high notes. Okay? Now, you can harmonize with the rest of the chord. You can harmonize with the B string all the way. And that gives a fuller sound, because you play the G string as your second bass note. And that's the end of the next part. That's the next riff. That's it. I told you, it's gonna be a lot easier than the first part from now on. Now you play a solo. You play this. It's a really nice solo. It's kind of it's a half arpeggiated solo. There's a nice trick to it, because this is dissecting a D7 chord. Because this is D7, you just take it apart into open strings. On the E string, it's 2, pull off to 0. Then on the second string, it's 1. And then 1 again, and then pull off to 0. And then on the third string, it's 2, pull off to 0. Okay, so it's this. And then a small country lick. Put your first finger on the third string on 2. And then this. Second finger on the D string on 3, and you hammer and you play that and hammer on the third finger on four on the D string, so it's 3-4. Okay? And then you play two on the G string. Okay? Twice. And then with your second finger, this is important, with your second finger you play 3-2 on the A string. Okay? Why is this important? Because now you put on a G7. Okay? First finger on one on the E string and third finger on the G bass. Three on the E bass. Okay, so it's... Okay, so... Okay, now, even though you pick... You pick... Okay, you should pick it with feel. It's okay. It should be da 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 now. Okay, you should use dynamics here. You don't pick it flatly. You don't do it. You do it. Okay, you accentuate some of the strums. Okay, so from here, okay, and then this, okay, this is a little lick, which kind of prepares you for something you're gonna play in a little while. Okay, you play A7, you play the A bass, and then you play the chord. So it's... And then you play... Just up, down. Okay, so it's... Dum, dum, da, dum. Think drama. This is a dramatic part. And then you slide up to 11. But keep the second. I should have mentioned this. Play the A7 chord with your second and third fingers. This is really, really important because you want to change this into this. You don't want to change this into this and just move on and change all your fingers. You want to keep the second finger on the D string at all times. You were here, it was a major sixth. Now you want a minor sixth. Now you're at 11, just turn it into a minor sixth. Instead of third finger on 11, just put the first finger on 10. Okay? So it's... And after you're done sliding, you should already be in the minor sixth position. You change it along the way. Just change it along the way. You begin a minor, you change it along the way, and you land here. Begin on A7. And you end on F sharp minor. Okay? No, it's not F sharp minor, it's A. Okay? It's A, it's not this. It's this. It's still A. Steve Howe is smart, I told you, he's an extremely smart guitar player. It's another version of A. And then he takes this, takes it two frets down, from 10 and 11 to 8 and 9, and then it's back to major 6 on 7 and 7 on the B and D strings. 7 and 7, this is a D chord, and then this. 5 and 5, which is A7. Okay, it's this. So it's 2 and 2 on the B and D strings. Of course it is. It's A7. And then 10 and 11. 8 and 9. 7 and 7. 5 and 5. Okay? Remember this. This is going to play a big part in a little while. So we were here. Okay, 2 pull off, 1-1 pull off, 2 pull off, country lick, 3-2 to G7, A7, okay, and now for the next part, okay, let's play it up to speed. You're back to the beginning, only you just play the first 2 chords. Okay? D and G. Okay? This shape, the bar with the pinky, and then the C chord shape. Exactly the same thing. Okay? And then take it down 2 frets and play it again on 5. Okay? Pinky on 10. Then take it back 2 more frets and play it on 3 with the pinky on 6. Oh, pinky on 10. Pinky on 8. The pinky was on 10 at the beginning. So it's on 7. 5, 3, then on 2 with a pinky on 5, and then G and C. Okay, it's just up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Okay, with accentuations on the down. Got it? G, C. And then you play the first riff again on 10 this time with the pinky on 13. Okay? And then on 10 with on 8. What do I have with 10 today? Then on 8 with your pinky on 11. So you were on 10, then on 8, and now you're moving on to the next lick, which is this. Okay? And then this. Okay? But let's wait with this one. Let's play this. Again, the first chord. Okay? Now, the difference is that you play an open A chord as your bass, okay? So it's bass, chord, bass, chord, bass, okay? That's it. Now the second half of the lick. Just this. First finger is still barring the 7th fret. Second finger on 8. Pinky on 10 on the B string. Okay? The 8 is on the E string. So it's E string on 8, B string on 10. And then, again, Steve Howe changes it. So you can either play it twice, or play this, then take your second finger off of 8 and play 7 and 10, okay, on the E string and B string. Keep the pinky on. So it's either 8, 10, 8, 10, or 8, 10, 7, 10. Okay, now this riff comes around twice, So you can play 8-10, 8-10 the first time, and then 7-10, 7-10 the second time. So, slowly, so you can listen to the bass notes. Again. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, that's the rhythm. Now, D. You play bass chord. Again, second bass note is the G string. So you play the D and G strings as your bass notes with the thumb. Now, first time you play both E string and B string. Second time you just play the B string. Okay, so it's bass, chord, bass, B string, bass. Got it? Then you change this into D7, and there's another half banjo roll. It's this. It's both D string and B string. And then you play the G string. Okay, so it's... And then D string, open B string, and then G string. Okay, so it's D7 to D6. It's D7 to D6. Take the finger off. Remember, just like this. This was D7 as well. Only this time, this wasn't D6. It was kind of a D add 11, but let's not get into it. We were here, in case you don't remember. And if you don't remember, that's not good. You're not following. Concentrate. Go drink something, wash your face, come back, and continue. Now, so it's second and fourth strings, third string, then take the finger off and play strings 4, 2, 3. Now this is one continuous line. Got it? Okay? So you had this. Okay? Then just play it again. And then you play this again. Okay? You play both riffs again. And then this again. And then the last lick again. Okay? The D7 to D6 again. Okay? So let's call this A whatever, okay? So, A whatever, D, D7, D6, A whatever, D, D7, D6, D7, D6, okay? And then you play another solo, this. It up a little. Never mind. This part we just learned. Okay, you just finished another part. Congratulations, you're doing great. The beginning two chords on 7, on 5, on 3, on 2, G, C on 10, on 8, then a whatever D, D7, D6. This is not a whatever, by the way. I just call it a whatever because it's an A bass. It's D. It's D over A. Again, it's the same chord. It's just D over A. It's not A11 add sharp 13 or something. It's D over A. Don't worry. D. D7, D6. Then again. D7, D6 again. You're done with this part. Now, the solo. The second solo. Okay, this solo is a bit more complicated than the first, obviously. It's a country solo. You begin with this. You prepare the fingers on 2, 4, and 5 on the G string. Okay? And you pull them off in triplets. And then you pull off 3, 2, 0 on the D string. Okay, again, triplets. I'm gonna explain in a second. Don't worry, just let's go over it first. Then again, 3-2-0, double pull off on the A string. So it's all triplets. It's da 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 da. It's 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. Okay. Okay. So it's 5-4-2 on the G string, 2-3-0 on the D string, 2-3-0 on the A string. Hammer on to 2 on the E bass. And then this. Okay? Hammer on from 0 to 2 on the A string. And then D. Just open D string. Then 2 on the A string again and open D string again. So it's hammer on the A string, D. 2 on the A string, D. Okay, that's the first half of the solo. It's this. Okay, this. It's just a country lick. This is a scale. This is a country lick. Again. 1-2 on the A, on the E string. Hammer on to 2 on the A string, D string, 2 on the A string, D string again. Okay? I hope you got it. Now this. It's prepare your first finger on 2 on the G string. Third finger on 4 on the D string. Pick that. Then on the G string, it's either 2 hammer on to 4 and then pick 2 again. Or you can hammer on the 4 and pull off to 2 again. Okay, just remember that it's not a fast pull-off. This note, the B note, it's a note on its own. It's not an embellishment. It's not... Okay? It's three notes. Or you can pick it. Or you can hammer it on. And then pick. Which is the country way of doing it. Which is the original way that Steve Howe plays it. Okay, hammer on and then pick the two again, the A note. Okay, now it's this. Okay, it's just a lick, which is basically the same lick inside the scale and jumps a fourth up and then a fifth up. So, let me show you what I mean. I mean this. Now this ends up here, which is exactly the same notes, an octave up. So this jumps here, a fourth up, and this jumps a fifth up and completes an octave. Okay? Now you play this. Again, 5-2-4-2-2 on the G string. Pull off the same thing you started the solo with. Then 4 on the D string and 2 on the G string, which you just played in the previous leg. Okay? Keep that in mind. Try to see patterns. Again, it makes everything a lot easier. Hey, it makes it easier to memorize as well. And then the same thing, down one string, up one fret. Only this time, instead of the third finger on the G string, use your second finger and play 4 again, okay? Because that's the note you need in the scale. So, okay, it's on the B string. It's 6-5-3. Okay, 6-5-3. And then 4 on the G string and 3 on the B string. Again. So it's... And then, up one string to 2 frets. So you're playing 8-7-5 on the E string, and then again with the 3rd finger, on 7 on the B string, and 5 on the E string. Okay? So, from 5, from 6, from 8. And this is the solo. Okay? So we were here. Howe brings you into kind of a relaxation part where it's only strums. Now this is one of the most this is one of the easier parts to play. It's a lot of fun and there's a lot to do with it. So let me just play it first and then we're gonna break it down. So you're here and then. G head and you're on G7 again. So you're on G7. Okay? Now what you play is, again. Okay, you play. Okay, and you accentuate. Okay? Okay? And then this. Okay? This is a pretty strange line, but its logic is that it's a series of, it's D7, but it's supposed to be a diminished sound. It's supposed to be a. Yeah, diminished riff. And the diminished chord serves to just. It's like erasing a blackboard. You just listen to a series of riffs and solos and ingenious melodies. And what this does is refresh your ears a little, so you're free and fresh to go forward into the next couple of riffs. Okay, I hope this makes sense. If it doesn't, then never mind. Just play this. It's D7, okay? Now, D7, let's say that D7 is on 2. Okay, because we're looking at the E string, it's easier because the melody is. Okay, that's what you hear in your ear when you listen to it. You don't think, oh, it's a D7 chord that's moving around. No, you think, da-na-na-na-na-na-na. You're listening to the high note. That's what we are used to listening to. Now, so we're playing the D chord, okay, on 2. Okay, let's look at the F sharp note. On 2. And we do. Then we slide it to 5. And we play 5. So it's da na na da, do 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 5. Then it's 7-7. Then you add the pinky on 8. Okay? And then 4-2 again. So it's 2-2-2-5-7-7-8-4-2. Okay? It's just. Okay? It's just this. Because this is also a diminished movement, and this is also a diminished movement. Let's not get into theory too much. We still have a long way to go. So. Okay? It's 2-2-2-5-7-7-8-4-2. Okay? Now, 8, you can also choose to move your chord into it. Okay, it sounds good. Instead of just using your pinky. Again, Steve Howe alternates between those choices. This was moving the chord around or just the pinky. Okay, it sounds almost exactly the same. Anyway, it's too short of a time to even notice the change, but it makes a difference if you stay on the chord or move it around. Okay? Your choice. Again, whatever sounds good to you. Alright, so then you've got this. Okay, we're back to the A7, and now let me just prepare you for what you're going to play. You're going to play a series of sixths. If you are watching this channel regularly, you know that I hate this word, sixths. So it's on 2 and 2. It's a major sixth, and then it's on 3 and 4. 3 on the B string and 4 on the D string. And it's a minor 6. Then 5 and 5, 7 and 7, 8 and 9 as we've played earlier, 10 and 11 as we've played earlier, 12 and 12, and 14 and 14, which is an octave above the A7. Okay? So we're actually gonna play an entire scale in sixth. Now, this is a series of licks, as usual, but it's in rhythm. So, again, you play the A bass, then the A7 chord, and then da-dum again. Okay, boom, da-dum, da-dum. That's the rhythm. And then 3 and 4, and then 5 and 5. So it's da-dum, dum. Got it? It's da-da-da-da-da-da. Okay, that's what you should hear in your head. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And then it's got a series of endings. First ending is 7 and 7 and 5 and 5. Okay, and the rhythm is do-do-do-do. Okay, and then you play the rest of the bar, just the high notes, and lower the volume. Okay, just be very, very delicate. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, you lower the volume, and then back to the beginning. So, the entire lick. Now again, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then it's what we've played earlier. It was 10 and 11, and then 8 and 9. Okay, and this time it's again, lower the volume, and then again. And now it's 14 and 14, and 12 and 12. Lower the volume. Now we're moving on. So first ending 7 and 5, second ending 11 and 9, third ending 14 and 12. Okay, so let's play this. Playing 11 and 10 and 9 and 8. Then again 14 and 12. And then 9 and 11, 10 and 9 and 8 again. Okay? Like this. Okay, this was the ending. Now. After each couplet. Now you play, now we're going to do the next part, which is a more dramatic part. It's this. Okay? It's again those four chords: 14 and 14, 12 and 12, 11 and 9, 11 and 10, and 9 and 8. Okay? And it's da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- Okay? Before we move on to the ending riff, to the riff, it's not a riff, it's a series of chords. We can call it a long lick. Before we go to the next series of licks, that's the definition, the next series of licks, let's play this again, okay? So you can hear it in context. Drama. last series of licks. Then, let's wait with this one. 14 and 12, and then 12 and 12, add your pinky on 14 on the E string, okay? So it's 14 and 14, 12 and 12, and then add the pinky on 14. And then 11 and 10, and then 9 and 8, and then add your pinky on 10 on the E string. Okay? And then 7 and 7 and 5 and 5 and add your pinky on 7 on the E string. And this time you keep on picking. And then C shape up to fret to D, this is the add 9, add your pinky on the E string on 5. Okay, now the rhythm is da na 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 na. Okay, it's okay. The accentuation comes around every 3 strums. Da 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 da. Okay, so it's alternating between an accentuation on the downward strum and then an accentuation on the upward strum. So it's. Okay. First you accent the, you accentuate the bass notes, then you accentuate the higher notes. Okay? Try to listen. Okay? And then you take this 2 frets back to C, and the pinky is still on the E string, this time it's on 3. And then it's E7 over G sharp. It's E7, and add G sharp with your pinky on 4 on the E bass. Now, Steve Howe sometimes slows down when he plays this, sometimes he doesn't. Both versions work, by the way. Let's play this again. Series of chords. It was a series of chords up till now, but there were many open strings that stayed the same. It was a vamp. Now, a series of chords. A minor, G, A minor, G. C, F, D, G, E. Okay? Again, A minor, G, A minor, G, C, F, D, G, E. Okay? I don't know if he stole it or not, but it's the same series of chords that leads into the chorus of Classical Gas. Okay, this is E. So it's A minor, G, A minor, G, C, C, F, D. But as been said many, many times, good musicians copy, great musicians steal. I think that it's been said about artists in general. I think Picasso said it. I'm not sure, but it's true. If Eric Clapton admitted of stealing the chords for Layla from an old blues song, then I'm pretty sure that Steve Howe did steal this. But even if it didn't, it's still ingenious. So A minor, G, A minor, G, C, F, D, G, E. Okay? Now, if you slow down, it sounds like this. continue. Into the next riff. If you don't slow it down, then it just continues on the same rhythm. So it's... Okay? The next... Like... No. Let's have patience and play the whole part. To the lesson at the end there. So the next lick is this. This is, by the way, an ingenious, one of the most genius transitions I've ever seen. Okay, from a chord, an atmospheric chord part into back into country. Unbelievable. I love this this moment. So it's on the E string. 4-5-7. Okay, sometimes Steve Howe just plays 5 and 7. Okay, plays 5 and 7 and moves on. He doesn't play the G sharp note sometimes. Okay, so you can. Okay, so it's. Okay, it does that. But the full transition is 4-5-7. Okay? Okay? So 4-5-7 and then this chord. 3 on the D string with your first finger. Second finger on the G string on 4. Pinky on 6 on the B string. Okay? So it's 3-4-6. This is G7 again, okay? Just taking these notes and playing them. So, you play this. You play the D string, and then you play the B and G strings. And then you play this again, and you take the finger off of the D string, and you play an open D string. Okay? And then you put it on again, and you play the D string, then strings 2, and then 3. Okay? And then take it again, and you play the open D string again with the chord, and then you put it on again, and you play the D string on 3. So it's on, off. Whole chord and move it up one fret to 4-5-7, and instead of the open D string, you play the open A string. So, okay, got it. So it's the D string on 4 chord, A chord, D string on 4, roll, A string chord. D string on 4. And then those two licks again. this twice. You play the G, you play the G7, and then you play the G sharp 7, and then you play the G7 again, and the G sharp 7 again. Now, instead of the last D string, you play this. Okay? Because it's this. It's a movement into a G, it's a transition into an E7 flat 9. Flat 9, sharp 9 chord. 7 sharp 9. Now, you just play the E bass on 3 and you bend it down. Okay, and then you play the open E string and you go here. Okay? To the dominant sharp 9 chord. So. Okay? When you play the E string, you jump here. Okay, and get ready for the next lick. Now, this is the chord. Okay, but this chord itself, the bluesy chord, will come around later at the end of the clap. Now you're gonna play a solo on it. You're gonna play. Okay, you're gonna play on the B string with your pinky. This is still on. You play 9, 9, 7, and then open E string, then 7 again. Okay, it's 9, 9, 7, open E string, 7 on the B string again. So it's. Now, the chord is still on because you can harmonize with it, with the G string, and the second bass note, the alternating bass note, can be either the A string on 7 or the D string on 6. So, okay, both sound good. You can even alternate between them. If you want. So you play this and you jump right into the chord. You jump right into the solo. Okay? So it's da 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 da. That's the rhythm. Try to listen to the bass notes. Okay? Look at my thumb. Okay? And then, remember this chord? You played it before on G and G sharp. Now you're gonna play it on A. So you're gonna play it on 5 this time. So it's 5, 6, and 8. This is A7, so you play the A bass, and you play this. Okay, now there are two ways to play this. You can either play the A7 chord, or you can play an A chord, okay, with 5 on the B string, 6 on the G string, 7 on the D string. Okay, and then it's an A major chord. Okay, now the solo is the bass, then the solo begins. It's 8 and 7, then it's hammer on and pull off from 5 to 7 to 5, okay, and then 6 on the G string, which is on either way. If you play this, then it's on, and if you play this, it's on because this is the major note of the A chord. So it's this note, it's the C sharp note, and then 5 on the B string again. So it's okay, it's 8, 7, hammer on, pull off, 5, 7, 5, and then 6 on the G string, 5 on the B string again. So with both chords. If you play this with the 7th chord, you bar the 5th fret. Because you need this, so bar. Okay? The alternating bass notes, of course, are A and D. If you play this with A, then you have no problem, you don't have to bar anything, you're already on 5. Okay? The only thing that changes is whether you're on 5 or on 7 on the D string. You decide which you like. I personally love the 7th chord sound. Gives it a sultry feel. I don't know, sort of, I don't know, a funky feel, a funky sound to it. And then this. Okay? Now, Steve Howe used to play it like this. But now he plays it like this. He has extra long fingers, so he can. He plays it like this. Okay, you can either put on the E note, 7 on the A string with barring like I do, or you can just put on 7 on the A string and 6 on the D string as he does and just alternate between basses. Anyway, the bass notes I play are the E string and the A string. Both are E notes, it's an E octave. Okay, it's an open E string and 7 on the A string. I bar on the 7th fret, and I leave the E bass open, and the solo is... It's 10 and 9 on the E string, 7 on the E string on the bar, and then I take the bar off, I bend just a little, just to take it a bit off. Off key, I mean, on 8 on the B string, and then I play open E string, then 8 again on the B string. So it's... Now it's important to just stop pressing for a second when you play the open E string, so you don't get this. You don't want them both playing, it's a solo, so... Okay, take it off for a second, then put it back on. Just stop pressing and repress. So, okay, when I take the bar off, I just play the E string all the time, the bass, the E bass. Now, you can keep your first finger on the E note on the A string, and then you're set. You can continue the alternating bass notes. I just got used to it the wrong way, so I keep playing the E bass at the end there. But you don't have to. You can keep the finger on. If you want to do it the Steve Howe way, the stretchy way, just put on these two and just use your pinky for 10 and 9 and your third finger for 7 on the E string and then pinky on 8. Now then you need to bend it a little with your pinky. Okay? This is the less comfortable way. But both work. Okay, now slower. Listen to the bass notes. Okay. Okay, it's all the same pattern. Da, 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 da. same pattern. It's down, 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 down. Okay, with small variations, with the hammer-on and pull-off on the A chord, and with this, with the small bend. Okay, but it's the same pattern. Just get it in your ear. Learn to listen closely and search for repetitive patterns, because music in 99.99999999 ad infinitum, that's how you say that word, ad infinitum. What was I saying? Never mind. Oh, that music is repetitive. That's how music gets you. It repeats something. So just learn to search for it. Wow, this is a long lesson. Anyway, now you're here. We're getting close to the end, folks. We're getting closer to the final riffs. It's this. That's the next part. But let's play the previous part again. You've played this. A. Again. A. Two parts left, with a bit of a transition in between. So we can say we've got three parts left, and then we've got the final ending solo. So we can say that we have four parts left, but I like to think about it as two parts with a transition and the ending solo. Don't know. I find it more comforting than thinking about four more parts. Take the A chord, bar it on, take it back to the first fret, and then play it, and then slide it to two. Okay? Or I could just say bar the first fret up to the D string, leave the A string open, don't play the E string. Okay, just play this, and play it, and then slide into two. Slide into the A chord. Okay? And you play this. So it's da-da-da-da, it's slide A-A. Okay? Take your third finger, put it on four on the G string. Slide it to six. Use your second finger and play five on the E string. Then you're still on six on the G string. Slide it back down. Then pull it down. Pull it off to four. That's why you played it with your third finger, so you can pull it off at the end there. Okay. So, 4 to 6, 5, 6 to 4, pull off to 2, okay? And then, again, pull off from 4 to 2, still on the G string, then the same thing on the D string, pull off from 4 to 2. Okay, so it's... entire lick. The G string on four, slide to six, five on the E string, slide back, pull off to two, four, pull off to two again, then four, pull off to two on the D string. Now remember this, because this exact shape, exact movement repeats itself at the end of the clap here, and I'm not kidding, it's here. Okay, and then this again. Okay, and then you add another A. Okay, so it's slide A, A, A. Then this. Okay, because we're on A, so we're gonna use both a major pentatonic and a minor pentatonic. This is a major pentatonic, then we're gonna do exactly the same thing on the E minor pentatonic. Okay? So, two, pull off to zero on the E string. Two on the B string. Then, remember the second solo? Do it again. 5 to 4 to 2 on the G string, 4 on the D string. Motif, told you, it repeats itself. Okay, that's about the first quarter of the solo here. So, okay, 5, 4, 2 on the G string, 4 on the D string. So, 2, 0, 2, pull off, 4 on the D string. Then, 5 with your first finger. 5, because you're in a different scale. 5 on the E string. 8, 5 on the B string. Then, 8 to 7 to 5 on the G string. Then guess what? If you don't know by now, you should really think it over. 7 on the D string. Oh yeah, you have the answer right here on the tab. Anyway, okay, but you should have known it. You should have seen it coming. Anyway, 5, 8, 5, 8, 2, 7, 2, 5, 7 on the D string. Okay? Okay, it's the same pattern on the A major pentatonic scale than on the A minor pentatonic scale. Okay, you have no idea how much time it took me to get this simple lick down. I have no idea why. I played the entire composition perfectly. I always failed in this little lick. Don't know why, my fingers just refused to get it down. But I kept practicing until they finally caved and surrendered and did as I wished them to do. Now you're here, right? So you do this again. Okay, I mean again because you just played these notes. So it's 7 pull off to 5 on the G string, 7 on the D string, 7 on the G string. Okay, so it's sorry. Now it's hammer on from 5 to 6 on the G string. Then it's 7 on the D string. Okay, 5 to 6 on the G string. Hammer on. 7 on the D string. And then this little strange bit. It's 0, 5, 0 on the D string. And then it's 7 hammer on to it's 5 hammer on to 7. It's too many sevens. I'm sorry. It's 5 hammer on to 7 on A. Open G string. Again, this is where you stop pressing 7 on the A string. You don't want to get this. You don't want to get this. You don't want to hear them both. You stop pressing. So you only hear the G string. you play this again. And then you slide. By the way, there's a different way of doing this. You can do it like this. You can bar the fifth fret, and instead of the G string, play the D string on five. But again, you need to stop pressing with your third finger on the A string when you play the D string. So it's either open G string or D string on five. I prefer the open string sound. This time. And then you slide your first finger from seven, from five to seven. Why do I keep saying seven? It's like the, remember when I kept saying 10 here? I kept saying pinky on 10. No, sometimes the number gets stuck. Now you slide from five to seven on the A string. And before I tell you what's next, let's go over this again. Remember this? A again. Major pentatonic, minor pentatonic. Okay, I broke it down for you. Now let's play it in timing. Okay? Again, so you can hear the timing. Okay? It's okay, it's on the offbeat. It's one. Okay? I sang it in a different scale. You play the first four chords of the clap again. And then you play the first three chords again. And then B7. Because we're moving into E. Okay, this modulates into E. And the B7 is the fifth chord, the dominant chord of the E scale. So it gets the ear into the transition. So it helps the ear make the transition. That's a more pleasant way of doing it, of saying it. Again, four chords, again, then three chords, B7, okay? So, let's... first four chords again, this time two frets up. Instead of on the bar on seven at first, you start with a bar on nine. And you just strum it. It's actually, if you want to get really precise, so. By the way, accentuation, ta-da-ta, okay? The last strum is the strongest. Okay, you want to keep the rhythm going. Now, we're at the last finger-picking riff. The next part is my favorite part of the clap. It's a bluesy bit. I really love this one. It goes like this. Okay. the ending solo. So as you've seen, it's got two parts to it. Okay, the final part has two parts. The first part is this. Okay, you begin with the bend, the E bass bend on three, and then when you play the E bass, you're already here on the dominant sharp 9 chord, on E7 sharp 9, which is, again, it's this time the pinky is on 8. And you play this. You already played the bass. And you play this. Okay? It's strings. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3. That's it. Okay? With Travis picking. It's as basic as that. But it's a bit confusing for the ear because the open E string is a lower note than 8 on the B string. So it gets a bit confusing if this is your first time playing something complicated in fingerstyle with open strings in it. Okay, now let's play it slowly so you can hear the rhythm. Doesn't matter that I made a mistake, I wanted you to listen to the bass note. Again. I did this on purpose. I wanted you to listen to the bass note. Okay, I kept the rhythm going. I kept the correct rhythm when I played this, the high notes, but I wanted you to listen to how it gets together with the bass notes. Now I'm gonna play it right. So it gets together like this. Okay? Slower, it goes like this. So it's da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, and then doo-doom. Remember the F sharp 7 at the beginning, you play the same chord, C7 shape here on 9, 9 is the bass note, the first finger on 7, okay, with the pinky on 9 as well, on the G string. And you play this. Again, you play the bass note first, and then you play 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Okay? Strings. Strings 1 and 2. Open E string, and the B string is on 7. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. Okay? That's the rhythm. Slower. Okay? Listen to the bass notes. This is the bass notes. Da, 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 da. Okay? That's what you need to hear in your head in order to play this right. Both chords. Da, 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 da. Da, 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 da. Okay? Third chord is the A7 chord in the shape we've gotten so familiar with. On 5, 6, and 8. On the D, G, and B strings. With the open A chord. With the open A string. And you play this. Okay, just like the E dominant sharp 9 chord. The bass note first, then 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3. again. Okay, and the bass notes keep on going. Da, 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 da. Okay, listen to it. Again, slower, I'm gonna shut up. G string and an open E bass, and then two and two on the same strings, G and E bass, and then you just move it around to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, it's just E, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so it's. You can play a little bit with this one as well. You can mute the notes to create your own little timing here. You can do it in several different ways. Let me try and show you. This is without muting. Okay, this is with muting every two times. This is just random muting. This is changing the rhythm entirely. Okay? You can do whatever you want with it. Be creative. Now comes the second time around. Second time around is the same three chords. What was that? Okay, it's the E dominant sharp 9, F sharp 7, A 7. Only this time you have a little solo embellishment between them. You have this, and then you have this, and then you have this again. Okay, you add, with your pinky, you add a pull off on the E string on 9. Okay, just to an open E string. And then on the, on both E and A 7 chords, you play the play 8 on the B string again, and then the open E string again. So it's the same solo on E and A. It's 9 to an open E string, 8 on the B string, E string again. Okay, and it's just the 9 to 0 on the F sharp chord. I'm preparing you. I want you to know what you're going to play, because if you know the small difference, then it helps you absorb the material before we get into the chords themselves. So, okay, you play bass and then strings 1 and 2 on the E chord, and then then the lick, pull off, 8, open E string. Now when you play the 8 with your pinky, if you can, bend it a little, okay? It's, I know it's a bit difficult, but work on it, it's worth it, it's a lot of fun. Now, when I just started playing this lick, I let go of the entire chord and just played the solo because I liked it so much. But I don't recommend it. Try the harder way. Learn to operate the pinky. Thank you. sharp 7. Again, bass, then 1 and 2, strings 1 and 2, and then pull off, and then take the pinky back to 9 on the G string and play it. Now this is the same note as the open E string, but that's what's cool about it, because it creates a double effect. Okay? Instead of playing the E string twice, which makes the note stop for a second, you just play it on a different string. I told you, it's a really smart composition. Okay? Listen to the bass notes. Now on the A string, it's the same rhythm and the same lick as the E 7. Did I say A string? I meant on the A chord. Okay? Messed it up a little. Bass. Bass, 1, 2, pull off, bend, E string, okay? Try to keep the sequence in your head. Now the ending solo. The ending solo goes like this. And then it's a series of banjo rolls. Two different endings, either the original ending or the new ending, and then the original ending. Let's go for it. I hope you're as ecstatic as I am. This has been a long lesson, and you're about to finish learning how to play the clap. I'm really excited for you, really. I'm not just saying it. Congratulations, really. This, I know how tough it is. Bar, the 9th fret, on strings 1, 2, 3, and 4. And prepare the pinky on 12. I know this is like closing a circle because it's the same shape of the chord you started with, but this time you're gonna play a scale. You're not gonna play a chord. You're not gonna play. Okay, you're not gonna play it again. You're gonna play the major pentatonic scale, the E major pentatonic scale. So it's 12, 12, pull off to 9 on the E string. 12, 12, pull off to 9 on the B string. 11, pull off to 9 on the G string. Okay? Okay? You can also do it like this without the bar, but it's a lot easier with the bar. Okay, because it's supposed to be fast, so why not? as long as it don't get any, okay, with these notes still ringing. Keep it a solo, separate notes. Now, remember when I told you you're gonna play this again? Now's the time. Okay? It's the same movement on the G string. You're on 11 with your third finger. Slide it to 13. Second finger on 12 on the E string. Slide back on the G string from 13 to 11. Pull off to your first finger on 9. 11 to 9 again, pull off on the G string, then on the D string, 11 to 9, okay? Same thing. Same thing, different scale. Okay? Same shape, same pattern, same fingering, only a different scale in a different context, okay? So, pull off, pull off, pull off, entire lick again. Now this, the same country cliche, we've played three times before. We've played it here, we've played it here, in a bit different way, and we've played it here. Now we're playing it here. It's 9 to 11 on the D string, and you bar the 9th fret, and you play 9 on the G string. Okay, so it's 9 to 11 on the D string, hammer on, and then 9 on the G string. Twice. Okay, so it's... So... Then this, which is third finger on 11, slide it back to 9, then pull it off to 7, okay? Third finger on 11, I said. You need your first finger, so slide back, pull off. Then 9, pull off to 7 again, just like this. It's actually exactly the same, only an octave down. Okay? And sliding way back down instead of just... Okay, so it's... 11, slide back to 9, pull off to 7, then 9, pull off to 7 again. Then 9 on the E bass. By the way, I'm not sure I said this, but this is on the A string. Don't know if I mentioned that. Then on the A string, 11 to 9 to 7. Then 9, 7. Then 9 on the E string, slide way back down. And then E. E chord. Okay, so... So it's this. Into it to play it. It's a piece that demands you to be entirely 100% concentrated in playing it. You need to be one with the clap, with the piece. You need to be one with it in order to really enjoy it. Okay, and then this. It's a series of banjo rolls. You play the open E string, just as a transitional note. Bar, strings 1, 2, and 3 on the 3rd fret. Pinky on 6 on the 3rd string, on G. I know you're barring it, but you're going to take the bar off and leave this note on, so trust me. Bar, 3rd fret, 1, 2, 3, strings E, B, and G, 6 on the G string, and you've already played this, remember? And then you played strings 3-1-2. Okay, I know this sounds bad, but that's how it's supposed to sound. Okay, it's supposed to sound weird. So it's, okay, this is an open E string. Then, take everything off, just leave the first finger on 3 on the G string and play strings 3-1-2 again. Okay? And then 4 on the D string and play the open B and G strings. And then 4 on the A string and play open B and G strings again. I know this sounds weird, but it actually outlines this chord. It outlines the F sharp chord for some reason. It's this. Okay? It's weird, but it works. Okay? So 6-3-3, 3-0-0, then 4 on the D string, open 2nd and 3rd strings, 4 on the A string, open 2nd and 3rd strings, hammer on from 1 to 2 on the A string, and the open E and B strings. Okay, why? Because this is B, and as we said before, B is the dominant chord of the E scale, and then this brings us back into E. Okay, it's a really smart transition back into E. So, okay, before we get to the final solo lick, again, 6-3-4, strings 2 and 3 this time, 4-1-2, back to strings 1 and 2. And then this, which is similar to this, but it's not the same this time. Third finger, because you're gonna need the first finger again. Third finger, slide from 2 to 4 on the G string. Open E string, then pull off from 4 to 2 to 0 on the G string. And then 2 again. You've already played this. Remember when? You played this in the first ending of the first part. Remember? So, okay, slide from 2 to 4, E string, double pull off, 4, 2, 0, 2. Okay, on the G string. Then hammer on from 0 to 2 on the from 0 to 1, excuse me, from 0 to 1 on the G string, and then 2 on the D string. And then you either play this chord. No, actually, you either play the bass note and then this chord, which we'll get to in a second, or you play the more recent ending and then you play this chord. The recent ending is this. Okay? It's natural harmonic on 7 on the A string, then the E string. And then 6 on the D string and 8 on the G string with the pinky, because you need to really bend it in order to keep the E string and B strings open, because you need to play natural harmonics on the B string and then the E string after you play this with your third finger. You just lightly touch them and then take it off. So it's harmonic, harmonic, 6, 8, harmonic, harmonic. Okay? Down the guitar. So final chord. Now sometimes it plays it like this. Okay, sometimes it plays it. Again, he does whatever he wants to do. So you do what you want to do. I just like to end it. So harmonic, harmonic on 7, by the way. It's natural harmonic on 7. You have natural harmonics on 5, 7, and 12, and also on 3, and 4, and 9, if you are really careful in pulling them out. I'm talking about natural harmonics on 7. Then 6, 8, harmonics, then this. E bass open, bar on 11. Second bar with your third finger on 12 on the first and second strings. So it's open, E string, E bass, 11, 11, 11, 12, 12. It's a kind of 6-9 chord, if I'm not mistaken. Or you can call it 9-13 if you want. Why does it look like that? Because it's just like this is the back of the major pentatonic scale. This is its front. Okay, it's all of those notes. So just made a chord out of it. It wouldn't work anyway. It wouldn't work all throughout the neck. But because it's a high pitched chord, then it works just like this. Remember when we played this? Okay, why does this work? Because 12 and 12 are an octave above 0 and 0. But if you play this, it sounds lousy because it's all bass notes. And if you take some of them up an octave, then it works. Okay, it's the same chord, but it's beautiful this time, even though it's the same notes. It's a different pitch. So this is why this chord works. So there are times when he plays this. Solo. I'm gonna play it slow in a second. Okay? Slower. I just want to say something. By the way, if you're not a subscriber yet, please subscribe to my channel. I've got a ton of lessons. But that's not what I want to say. I just want to say thank you for sticking with this lesson up till here. I really enjoyed this. This is one of my favorite pieces. It's as fun to play as it's fun to listen to. And it's really hard not to get into it. Even if you play it lousy, and even if you can't get it right, it's still a lot of fun to play, and I can promise you that once you get it under your fingers and you play it and you succeed in playing it, you're gonna feel so awesome and you're gonna feel like you can play anything. And it's true, because you can. It only takes practice. So have patience, learn this slowly. Go download the tab from the website. The tab is also for free. This lesson is for free. Everything on the channel is for free. I love teaching guitar. And if you want to help out, there's a donation button on the website. And any donation whatsoever would be very, very, very generous of you. And it will help me make more lessons like this one. So go get this under your fingers. Enjoy it. Be patient. That's all I can say. Be patient. Have a lot of patience. It took me a long time to play it like this. Miracles don't happen technique-wise. They happen. There are prodigies. There are people who are instantly good. But talent is just 10% of the deal. Because even if you have talent, you still need to practice. You still need to work your way up and understand what you're doing. And that's what I've tried to do with this lesson. I've tried to tell you why everything is the way it is in this piece. If you have any questions, there are comments. If you have any requests, send them over. And I'd love to hear how this goes. Now I'm gonna go and drink something, water or juice or whatever, because I've been talking for a long time now. I really hope you succeed in playing this, and it's only up to you. And it's only up to you and the amount of patience you have, because that's all it takes. Patience. Patience and practice. And having fun. Have fun. Don't forget to have fun while practicing this. Enjoy it. Enjoy every note, every chord, every lick, every riff, every part, every solo, everything. Just like I've enjoyed teaching it. I'll see you in the next lesson. Thank you so much for watching.